Don't always struggle to be number one, but struggle to be the first.
Oh.
The first to change, the first to adopt, the first to start business, the first to innovate, the first to do it. And once you do that, you're going to find yourself in a blue ocean.
Jumbo, great people. I tell you, this is another exciting Friday. And I know today you see there's a lot of different things. I tell you, you are about to experience something different, something very energetic. And we are outside the norm. And today we are outside at the current. We're about to tell you where we are. But before then, I want to introduce my able mentor. We all know him. We love him. He teaches us a lot. Karibu sana, Mr. Washuri.
thank you.
How are you, Leo?
Thank you, DJ.
You're good?
And thank you for our viewers for locking in again in this particular Friday.
Yes.
And we are always happy when we talk about Fulahi Day.
Mm-hmm.
Because this is the day that we are able to mix with our fans.
Mm-hmm.
This is the day that people ask questions. This is the day that we are able to open up our hearts and talk what is in our hearts. And I'm so excited to see that today we are out of the four walls of the office, and we are in Karen.
I tell you, and today we have an exciting topic that we have aligned for you. So much in store for you.
Uh-huh.
Last Friday,
yes,
we talked about a very exciting topic, and I tell you, quite a number of people have told me they have gone for holiday.
Uh-huh.
We talked about burnout, how to deal with it.
Oh yes, oh
and
yes.
I feel like today we are exercising that. Today we are just free.
I remember you talked about when you have a burnout, you can stop working.
Yes.
You can go for a walk.
Mm-hmm.
You can just take a break. You can talk to your supervisor and say, hey, George, I am tired. I am going home. And I'm happy that our viewers out there, they are actually practicing what we are talking about, because life is about the way you make it.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you want to be complicated, you want to be stressed, you can be stressed.
Yes.
And by the way you get stressed, get depressed, you will die and leave people eating and drinking at Itana Roti.
You don't want to die. You don't want to die.
No.
We want you to live.
Mm-hmm.
And today we have a very exciting topic. How to see opportunities. Oh
wow.
My.
I like it.
How to see opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell you, that is a topic. I need you to tell a friend to tag along. And tell them, we are Facebook Live at DJ Covenant, at George Washuri, at Optiven Limited. Ask any question. And today, we are going to introduce something that you want to hear it, and you won't hear it anywhere.
Wow.
Mr. Washuri,
yes.
we go straight to our topic.
Uh-huh.
What is the difference between people, because now we're talking about how to see opportunity.
Uh-huh.
There's another word, looking.
Oh, yes.
What is the difference between seeing and looking?
Wow, I read this from a certain entrepreneur, a top range entrepreneur, Jack Ma. There's a difference between looking at the opportunities and seeing the opportunities. They say that people are different. There are people who just look and see things happen.
Mm-hmm.
There are other people who look and they wonder why things are happening.
Mm-hmm.
Other people look at it and say, hey, I'm going to take action. The time you take action, we talk about seeing opportunities, capturing those opportunities, grabbing those opportunities, because life is full of issues. And our viewers, they have a duty to decide, am I an onlooker or am I a participant?
Mm-hmm.
And once you participate, you are able to see the opportunities available. Some people, look at Nigeria. Nigeria is one of the most populated country in Africa.
Yes.
And when they see these people, they see a big population. But entrepreneurs don't see people, they see markets.
Ah.
They see, how can I provide water for these people? How can I provide food for these people?
Mm-hmm.
Kenya today, you're talking about 51 million people. There are people who say, hey, we are giving birth very fast.
Yes.
Other people are saying, hey, this is market being created. And I'm happy today we came to the waterfront.
Mm-hmm.
This is one of the newest malls in this republic.
Mm.
And there's no other mall that is beautiful as the waterfront mall.
I tell you.
And if you have not seen it, please come to Karen. Right now the bypasses are being made.
Mm-hmm.
You see a kind of a mall with a lake behind the mall.
Mm.
And we are saying, these are opportunities available for you instead of you complaining every other day.
Mm.
And that's why we are here saying, this month, actually, DJ Covenant.
This month.
On the 15th, we are opening opportunities here for our people. Because remember, Optiven,
yes,
we talk about creating 30,000 jobs by the year 2030.
Mm-hmm.
As you look just behind us,
yes,
this is the newest brand in this nation. It is only found in South Africa.
Mm-hmm.
And today, On 15th of this month,
yes,
we are going to launch this particular brand.
Yes.
This is going to be the home of pizza.
Mm. One of a kind in Kenya.
Let me tell you, I know you have tasted pizzas, mm, but this particular pizza,
yes,
will make you go crazy.
Yes.
Because there's taste. So don't miss out. On 15th, we are going to give free pizzas, and we are going to be right here in front of this particular door. On 15th, the door shall be opened.
Yes.
And if you are our fan, please book your ticket right now. It is for free. You can come here and launch this particular shop, the Panarottis, because Kenya, we are on the move.
By default, I'll be there. you need to be here. Mr. Washori,
yes,
there are challenges all over.
Uh-huh.
And in the midst of us looking for these opportunities, how do you behave around all this? Or how do you navigate around it?
Somebody says that there's no business without challenges, because business is about offering a solution to a certain challenge.
Yes.
So when you see challenges, these are exciting opportunities, because the business belongs to the people who sort out problems. Mm-hmm. Without problems, we're not talking about business. So when you see challenges, don't just look at the challenges. See the challenges. And mm-hmm, once you see the challenges, offer a solution. When you offer a solution,
mm-hmm,
the African people, the Kenyan people are willing, mm-hmm, to pay for the solution. And that's why we say that don't complain about challenges.
Mm-hmm.
Think retrospectively, mm-hmm, and think, what can I do to offer a solution?
Wow.
Yes.
If you have any question, mm-hmm, remember we are hashtag Ask Washori. Ile kitu yangu iko wapi?
Today we are at Panarottis. Today we are right here at Karen when at Panarottis.
When you,
yes,
know it's Friday, you know it's about Panarottis.
I can see DJ Kovere changing, but yes, we really appreciate our viewers,
mm,
and we are happy that you are with us today, Friday,
mm,
just here outside the Panarottis, and mm, we are promising you that for the coming days, mm, this is going to be real,
mm,
and I'm happy that most of our viewers are logging in,
yes,
and I can't wait to see some, yes, of our fans, mm, right here at the waterfront.
Around, we have competition,
mm-hmm,
now that we are very new and very exciting, uh-huh, I'm looking forward for this.
Yes.
There's a lot of competition, mm-hmm, around maybe our opportunities.
Yes.
What is your take on that?
Let me say that many a times as entrepreneurs, as business people, we always spread sleepless nights thinking about competition. Yet, I got something from Donald Trump,
mm-hmm,
that when you think of competition, don't lose sleep. Love them.
Mm-hmm.
Because competition makes us wiser,
yes,
sharper, more intelligent,
yes,
and we can be able to learn from them, because without competition, there is no move, there is no push for innovation, because mm, people innovate because of frequent competition. So for us at Optivin, for us at Panarottis, mm, we don't think about competition. We think about competing with ourselves. And you out there, maybe you have opened a shop,
mm,
a butcher somewhere, and you're saying there are so many butcheries. People go to buy meat where their butcher is.
Mm-hmm.
So competition also brings the customers.
Mm.
So don't complain about competition. Be grateful about competition, because competition makes us wiser,
mm,
sharper, more intelligent, and we become go-getters.
So when you see competition, you should be very happy,
oh, yes,
about it.
Oh, you can imagine DJ Covenant and, yes, our viewers. If God created you alone,
mm,
life could be very boring.
No.
We need people. We need 51 million Kenyan people. We need 1.2 billion people in Africa, mm, for us to be able to live a better life.
Wow. In that spirit of competition,
yeah,
we see a lot of failures,
mm-hmm,
that is happening nowadays.
Yes.
How do you go about it?
Let me say that every time you want to capture, to seize opportunities, failures is the best teacher. We are educated by failing, because when you fail, you learn a lesson.
Mm-hmm.
And you, as entrepreneurs out there, you can be able to study the people who have failed in the past. I'm given an example of the owner of Family Bank.
Mm.
This man looked for a license for 5 years. He was walking to Central Bank every other day to look for a license. But on the 5th year, he got a license.
Mm-hmm.
Today, the bank is among the biggest local banks. That means when you fail once, you fail twice. That's not the end. Draw the lessons,
mm-hmm,
wipe yourself, dust yourself, move, and capture the next opportunity.
Wow.
We can also learn from people who fail,
mm,
and then draw lessons. Forget, mm, about the success stories. Success stories, they're just to motivate you, to excite you, but success stories, you cannot learn anything from it.
Mm.
But ask people who have failed,
mm,
how did you rise up again? The Bible says you can fall 7 times, and the 8th,
mm,
you rise up.
You rise up.
Yes.
There's a friend of mine, we were having a discussion, but I didn't agree, but I would love to hear the opinion.
Uh-huh.
And this person was saying, if Mr. Washuri passed through this path and he got somewhere and failed, that person said, I would want to pass the same path and reach there and create now know how I got to go about that.
I think it's not good for you to copy Mr. Washuri. I failed 15 times.
Mm.
Don't feel like George Washuri.
Ah.
You can come to George Washuri. We can talk about mentorship,
mm-hmm.
because the same holes that I went down, mm-hmm. don't go back to
those holes.
Because I learned my lessons, and you can be able to learn from Mr. Washuri. You can read my book to see what are these challenges that I faced.
Mm-hmm.
So we tell people that we mentor, don't fail as many times as George Washuri.
Mm-hmm.
You can be better than George. You can be better than somebody else. That's why we advocate the issue of mentorship. And if you are there, you're watching this video live on Friday, please make sure that you have a mentor. It could be a virtual mentor, it could be a real mentor, a physical mentor.
Yes.
It could be a person who tells you as is. Mm. Very, very important. Mm. Yes.
Mr. Shuri, we like Optiven, we are known. We are the pace setters. Now this is the question. How do we become number one? How do we always be the first? Maybe the secret. Maybe someone is asking that secret.
I think DJ Covenant and our viewers, it is not important for you to become number one.
Mm.
Because in a marathon, there's only one gold winner. We can't all of us win gold. There's only one winner. And as a business person, as an entrepreneur, as a career person, don't always struggle to be number one.
Mm-hmm.
But struggle to be the first.
Oh.
The first to change, mm-hmm. the first to adopt, the first to start business, the first to innovate,
mm-hmm.
the first to do it. And once you do that, you're going to find yourself in a blue ocean.
Mm.
There are some people who are called laggards.
Mm.
They, for example, when the phones comes, they buy Samsung 9 when everybody else have already bought. Maybe this is the time they are now buying Samsung 7.
Those are laggards.
They are laggards.
Mm.
They are always behind.
Mm-hmm.
So be the first one to do stuff. And once you do that, you capture these opportunities, you see these particular opportunities, you'll be able to have an advantage, a competitive advantage of the being first, but not being number one.
Be the first, not be number one.
Exactly.
I think that one is important to capture. Be the first and not number,
not number one.
Because we cannot all be number one.
We can all be number one.
Yes.
Yes.
And now we say we are number one because of...
That's it.
Yes.
Because we took the first mover's advantage. This Panarottis is found in South Africa.
Mm-hmm.
I'm happy to say that a senior official called Ranesh is in the house.
Oh.
You know, he just came to see how this Panarottis is doing.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm happy that when you see him here, you know that by 15th,
15.
We are opening.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the first Panarottis, not only in Kenya,
yes,
the first Panarottis in East Africa.
Wow.
That means we are not number one, but we are the first movers in this particular brand. And I can tell you, this is going to be the game changer, not only in Kenya, but across East Africa.
This is not just pizza.
No, it's not just pizza. It's more than pizza. It's about bringing families together to smile.
I tell you, I love this. Maybe
there's somebody who's asking, George Bwana,
this
Panarottis, where is it?
Yes.
Maybe you can tell them exactly where is this store, Panarottis.
Waterfront.
Wow, Waterfront.
That is the newest, and it's one of the most beautiful.
Wow.
It's the beautiful ever you can ever see.
Fantastic.
And you will come here and you will... 15th, we eat free pizza.
I tell you, free pizza on 15th. And by the way, maybe you can tell our viewers,
yes,
in Panarottis, what is found? What is this so special? In fact, I saw the slogan for Panarottis is endless possibilities.
Mm-hmm.
Very inspiring, endless possibilities.
Oh.
What is happening in Panarottis? You can see behind the mall,
yes,
there is a man-made lake.
Oh.
Bwana, wacha kuleta watoto wakua wanasuba nyubani. Here they'll come and have water spots.
Mm.
There's a big supermarket.
Yes.
Just in front of us. It's a huge supermarket.
Very huge.
It's called Game Supermarket.
Mm.
And you can be able to come here and do shopping.
Mm-hmm.
As you do shopping, of course, you are getting hungry.
Mm.
As you get hungry, unaingia wapi? Panarottis.
I tell you. And you will have a lot of fun when you come here. I tell you. It's very beautiful.
Wow.
And we feel even relaxed.
We feel it.
Yes.
This is Karen, man. This is Karen.
And we tell them we have our new Karen.
Oh, yes.
At Amandridge.
That's it.
Yes.
That's it.
A very beautiful place.
That's it.
Ah, awesome. How do you prepare for the future? In between, we can need to ask, how does Optiven even prepare for that?
Let me say that for every person who wants to seize opportunities, every person who wants to see the opportunities available, you must prepare for the future. I was reading a story of Israel.
Mm.
When Israel was beaten, and it was there was no nation called Israel.
Yes.
But they were able to come back. Their population was below a million.
Mm-hmm.
But they were able to create the future by calling all the Jews in diaspora to come. And I was reading that book, I was imagining, how did they start? The same with our businesses. Maybe today your business is not doing so well. but you can be able to create the future for your business. I can give a good example of Optivate.
Yes.
Right now, we are classified with many awards on real estate.
Mm-hmm.
But the future, how does the future hold? We are looking at encouraging the young people
yes.
to come on board and join Optivate. Last week, we introduced what we are calling graduate mentees, whereby you are taking these university graduates. They have finished their courses.
Mm-hmm.
They are out there, and we encourage them to come to Optivate. They work with Optivate.
Mm.
If you are doing human resource, you come to human resource department.
Mm-hmm.
If you are doing ICT, you come to ICT department.
Yes. Yes.
And these people, we are mentoring them to be better people in the future. We are also launching the Optivate ICT Hub, whereby we are telling young people who are technologically empowered.
Mm-hmm.
People, these young guys, they think they are developing apps, and we are telling them, you can come to Optivate and develop that particular app. The first reward or the first award for the best app, we are giving a prize of $1,000.
Wow.
Number one. If you are number two, we'll give you $500. Number three, we are giving $250. That means you are a young person there, you have the brain, and
yes.
you can be able to develop an application. You can be able to log into our website, www.optivate.co.ke, and you can be able to compete for this money that we are giving our young people. Why? We are looking at the future, because the future of Optivate is technology.
Wow.
The future of Kenya is technology. The future of Africa is technology.
Yes.
Because everything now is technology. And for Optivate, we are very keen to ensure that we are creating this future to millions of young people out there.
I know there's this slogan, or people say, even there's been a song, I believe I can fly. I don't know. Does believing take part in seeing opportunities?
I think believing is one thing. Taking action is another. You must believe it. You must have hope. But you have to take real action.
Mm.
You have to walk the talk. You have to dig the foundation for you to be able to stabilize in your career, in your business, in whatever that you are doing.
So believing, you need to take action.
You have to take action.
There's an action point.
Oh, yes. You have to.
How can one be sober in the midst of confusion? I know, because there is, there are a lot of, when you talk about opportunities, there can be a lot of confusion here and there. How do you become sober?
I think for you to be sober, people are viewing this video, is that you have to make a solid decision to keep the focus.
Mm.
If you cannot keep focus, you can't be sober. You must make a decision to be physically fit. You must make a decision to ensure that you are eating well.
Mm.
You must make a decision to make sure that your body is good. Your mental faculties is also good.
Mm.
And once your mental faculties are good, you can be able to make well-informed decisions in your career, in your business, in your school, wherever you are, because you need soberness. And let me tell you, people who are working so hard in different organizations, it's important for you to take a break. That's why last week you talked about burnout.
Mm-hmm.
Don't just work. You collapse. And when you collapse, you bury you. When we bury you, go back with the work.
Yes.
So make sure that you have breaks in whatever that you are doing. Mm-hmm. Yes.
People are now confused about Easter. What do you do about Easter? Where do you go? We have a special something for them.
I thank God for Optivate. Because Optivate, we are always innovative.
Yes.
We are telling people to enjoy their Easter. Actually, it is Easter Bitter Stress.
Yes.
Hashtag Easter Bitter Stress. That if you invest in any particular property with Optivate, you only need to pay 700,000. You get yourself a senge, a boozy, with a crate of soda. And we escort you. So if you are out there, you are looking for a particular good property to purchase, we have various properties. We have a money reach whereby you are putting cabro roads, we are doing stone wall, we have security fence, and then the project is amazing because it's just next to the bypass.
Mm-hmm.
And this particular project, you can be able to get the size that you want. As long as you put 700 together, 700 pap, you get yourself a boozy for Easter. If you find a money reach is a bit expensive because you are selling at 4.1 to about 10 million, if you find this slightly higher than your budget, we have the Garden of Joy. It's only 1.195 million, and you're able to get your own property with water, with roads, everything done.
Yes.
And if you love Kitengela, of course, you have Victory Gardens, one of the most award-winning projects. The other day, the UN came to see how we have been able to make this Kitengela dry area green.
Mm-hmm.
We are doing biodigester. So we are actually incorporating the green energy within our projects. And if you are there, you can be able to find these particular properties on www.optivate.co.ke, or you can lift that phone, 0790-300-300. Optivate, we are here for you. We have been there for 20 years, so we are not We are not trying these things.
Yes.
We have been there and people have been supporting Optiven. We have thousands and thousands of customers who have got their own title deeds. Mm. We have over 10,000 customers with their own properties. So if you are there in the US, mm-hmm. in diaspora, in Europe, wherever you are, in South Africa, in East Africa, Optiven is your real partner. Mm. Because actually Optiven means optimizing ventures. Yes. And we are here to walk and work mm. with you.
And I quite a number of people are even confused because now they have so many places. They are saying, oh, I don't like that about pizza. Now they have a new place.
Oh, yes.
They don't have to be confused anymore.
I tell you, don't yes. be confused.
Yes.
We are talking about the new Panarottis, the new pizza mm. with a special taste. And by the way, it can deliver. We yes. can be able to deliver this pizza within mm-hmm. current surroundings mm-hmm. because we care about you.
I tell you, as Mr. Oshiri takes a sip of water, I want yes. to read a few couples of people who are watching us online. Asanteni sana for even sending us SMSs and even on Facebook Live. Remember, at DJ Covenant, at George Washori, at Optiven Limited. Remember, we had a Canadian in the studio last time.
Uh-huh,
yes. I see a lot of people from Canada. They're saying, lovely show there. Asanteni sana. I've seen Patrick Mwangi saying, wow, I have to be there on that date and eat pizza from Panarottis. there's a guy called James Mwangi. He's saying, wow, I love that offer for Mbuzified. I have to get in touch. Asante sana. And I've seen our very able. There's always there. She's always there. She's called Teresa Champes.
We value you.
We value you a lot. There's a day. You're yes. planning.
Mm-hmm.
People say maybe they go there, they don't, they are cheated. And with this day we want to tell them. This day we going to give titles.
Mm-hmm. Actually, I'm so happy that Aman Ridge,
yes,
the place of peace, within 8 months, the titles are out.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to announce dinner mm-hmm. for this particular day somewhere in Norfolk. We are going to give titles.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are there, you have not finished the payment of your property, you can be able to finish the payment so that you also enjoy the dinner as mm. you receive your title deed.
Mm.
And I'm so happy to see that Aman Ridge is yes. actually the new Mudhaiga.
Mm-hmm.
This is a project like no other project. When mm. I go to Aman Ridge, I don't want to leave. I want to be there. And yet, what you see at Aman Ridge today is only 20%.
Mm.
We are talking about putting facilities to make sure that 80% is done. And Optiven, we are known to deliver mm-hmm. the promise.
Yes.
We promise, we deliver. We promise title deeds in 2 years. Within 8 months, mm-hmm. the titles were out.
Mm-hmm.
And we are happy for many customers who are supporting Optiven. Supporting Optiven means you are supporting families. Supporting Optiven means you are creating jobs because we have a target of creating 30,000 jobs. Supporting Optiven means supporting the future. And we value you.
There's a lady called Judy Joanne saying, hello guys, can you tell me again where you guys are?
I'm amazing. Panarottis or Optiven? Yeah.
Here, where we are now. Mm.
We are right here in the waterfront mall.
Yes.
This is a new mall that has been constructed. It's one of the most beautiful malls I've ever seen.
Yes.
And Panarottis, you are opposite the Game Supermarket.
Mm.
And it's a new shop, it's a new store.
Mm.
And you are telling people that on 15th,
mm.
please log in. We can come together here and enjoy pizza
mm.
right here at the waterfront current Panarottis.
Someone maybe there outside is asking, Mr. Ashuri, yes, we now have these opportunities. We have them.
Yes.
Is it possible even to have fun in the current world?
Oh, yes. They say that career without fun is boring.
Mm.
Business without fun is also boring. Being school and you don't have fun is also boring. That's why our children,
mm.
when they're in school, they play football, they go swimming, because you must mix.
Mm-hmm.
You must marry business, mm-hmm. career with fun. So make sure, all our viewers, make sure they have time to have fun.
Mm-hmm.
And even out in Optiven, every
yes.
Friday,
mm-hmm.
we have a dancing hour.
Mm-hmm.
We dance, and you can see that even myself, I dance.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you dance, something happens within your system. So if you are there, please don't kill yourself, man. Have time to have fun. Because
mm-hmm.
a lot of work
yes.
made Jeroge a dull boy.
Jeroge, don't be dull. Mm. And today today it's Friday. We must do that dance.
That's
yeah, as we finish this, because our time is well spent.
Yes.
And we say thank you very much for watching this FB Live. I don't know whether, Mr. Ishi, if you have parting shots.
I think it's to thank our thousands and thousands of viewers, to tell them that we really, really value every Friday we are here. Mm. Tell somebody that next Friday we are coming and you can be able to share the topics that you want us to discuss, because we are your servants. We are here to serve you. We dedicate these 30 minutes specifically for you, mm. because for me as George Washiri, I wouldn't be able to mentor thousands and thousands of youth out there, thousands of entrepreneurs out there, hundreds of business people, but use this particular forum to ensure that we mentor you, we talk to you, and of course, every quarter we have business clinic.
Yes.
Last time we had a beautiful one, and
very
another
beautiful.
One is coming in June. Please book your seat early. Last time we had to block people,
mm-hmm.
because people are so many. We told them now the seats are completely full.
Mm.
So for June business clinic, make sure that you book your space right away. Thank you.
See you next Friday. I don't know where now we will not be saying same place,
uh-huh.
because now we might be shifting.
Yes,
we might go to
uh-huh.
to the spa. Ego Speaks.
Maybe today we are coming for Panarottis.
Today it's from Panarottis. So, Asante Sana, we tell you,
we value you.